and welcome to Miley Cyrus, aka Hannah Montana.
How are you?
Good, thank you so much.
I probably shouldn't say this, but at times I get so scared when I think about the previous relationship we shared.
Certain things that you do in London that are very sort of English, like have you ridden on a London bus, for example?
I did the last time I was here, and it was actually because I came here and no one knew who I was. The show was barely out.
So you were
Right, so I was like, I'm gonna go. We did like some sightseeing. We were totally like the weird tourists taking pictures of everything and the telephone booths and all that stuff.
Eating fish and chips.
I did. I went to Harrods and got them, so I was very excited. I was shopping in Harrods, and then I was like, oh, they got food here too. So I was like, okay.
Nice place to stop.
Yes, very fun. I walked in there, I was like, okay, I cannot live in London because I will have like zero money because your stores are like crazy amazing.
The seven things I hate about you. The seven things I hate about you. Oh, you.
Now, let's talk music. Now, the new single's called Seven Things. What are the seven things?
Seven Things is basically, says you're vain, you're games, you're insecure, you love me, you like her, you make me laugh, you make me cry, I don't know which side to buy, your friends are jerks when you act like them, just know it hurts, I want to be with the one I know. And then the seventh thing is like that you love them so much. And so it's like basically about all like the horrible things that they do, and then the reason that you hate them the most is because you can't fall out of love with them.
Now, your new album's called Breakdown, and you co-wrote 8 of the tracks.
Mm-hmm.
What was your inspiration behind the album?
My inspiration was kind of like all the press and stuff write things and get their own like ideas of what they think happened in their life. And this was kind of like a, I'll tell you, but I don't want to talk about it ever again, you know, after this. And like,
this
it was
like
kind of
final statement.
Right, exactly. So it was kind of like my no comment record, I guess.
Now, we heard you had an early Sweet 16.
Tell me
about that.
It was so much fun. There was 7,000 people there. And it was, I performed and my dad performed. And that was my favorite thing, was my dad wanted to perform for me, so I love that. And then afterwards, after I had done all that and done all the red carpet, I came in, it was like, honestly, I wanted to start crying because it was like amazing. I felt like Cinderella for a night, and I got a dog as a present. I'll never forget, my mom was dancing with Goofy, and like I looked over there and she was dancing with him, and I had like my doggy, and I was just like, I started bawling my eyes out. I was like, I cannot believe this. I love my dog, and she's named Sophie, and we had so much fun. It was amazing.
Is it a poodle?
It's a poodle Maltese mix.
Oh, wow.
A malty poo.
Your hair, your eyes, your old device. When we kiss, I'm immortalized. You made me laugh, you made me cry, but I guess that book I'll have to buy.
Got some facts to establish how famous you are, because this is pretty impressive. You're featured on a Bart Simpson blackboard.
Oh, what?
When he's writing lines, Bart Simpson, and it says, the capital of Montana is not Hannah, so he just keeps writing that, isn't it? How cool is that?
That is so cool.
You know you've made it when you're on The Simpsons,
exactly.
Right?
Exactly, I'm so excited.
And finally, Time magazine voted you in their list of top most, 100 most influential people in the world today.
That's really cool. That was my coolest thing ever. I was like, I don't know how I'm influencing people, but I hope I am, because I have a song on my record that's called Wake Up America. So hopefully it's like with environment and just by hopefully just being a good role model, I hope people look up to me.
And lastly, since you're one of the most influential people, I want you to give me a bit of advice. I know I'm older than you, but I reckon I could learn something.
Stay positive and, you know, be like,